the poetic way. Asylum. That's you say Arkham Asylum?
Yes.
I don't think it matters. I think it matters a lot. As far as
Fountain of Dreams, game one.
As far as pronunciation
Yoshi.
Go, doesn't matter that much.
Not Yoshi. Luigi against Fox.
Alright, so, all Fox needs is to wait for Luigi to go over him, and then just shine on a shield, shine him off stage, and shine spike him. And then you've won.
See, the interesting thing is that Fox can't convert off the shine most times against Luigi.
You just get him
so
off stage
far.
With it.
If you don't get him off stage with it, then he's just on stage far away from you.
And that's fine. Then you just reset neutral. There's no downside.
Well, the downside is that you reset neutral. Which, I mean, in this case, sure, that's great.
Alright, do you think he could have...
If you're not a good player, if you're the worst player, you do not want to reset neutral.
Here's
Am I
what...
saying Asylum is the worst player? Probably. But, you know, for the sake of the point.
The most important thing to know when you're fighting Luigi is don't overextend. If you're like, you know how sometimes you're like, can I get one more hit in? Just don't go for it with Luigi. Yeah.
That. Because that's immediately what gets you hit by a missile.
Yeah.
Here's what you do is you kind of like fake it. You might do like
yeah. Let the nair come out.
Let the nair come out.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then you hit him. So you also have to be careful. Like, see, this is why you have to be careful at starting Luigi, because as slow and predictable as his recovery is, he does have a few tools that makes it just a little bit more tricky, especially for people like Spacey's.
I think baiting that out is always a good thing. I've noticed this might be like a habit of Yidus, is a lot of the time if he gets impatient, like on the far side of the stage, sometimes he'll just come in with the spinny thing.
Yes. And it works a lot of the time.
It does.
That move's amazing.
Well, because it lasts longer than you think.
It's apparently so bad, but it's actually like secretly the best.
That's another move that, like, growing up, I never fell for. Like, every time I got a cut across, but now it happens and I just get hit. So I don't
what
know.
What happened?
I got worse.
Oh, I see.
So, one of the best combo tools that you, I think what we're going to be seeing in this game is a lot of.
There it is.
Yeah, we're going to be seeing a lot of aerials / smash attack combos. But a really good tool that Luigi has for just extending combos against Fox, and it takes like the exact right DI to get out, is his up tilt.
Really?
Yes, it's a very good move, according to Voodoo Jin.
Okay. Well, who would argue that?
So it's like, especially if you're starting at low percent, like you can do like an up throw or something or a down throw, and they'll just fall, and you can get a few up tilts along the way, and then you move into your bigger hits, which will send you farther away.
See, but a lot of times you can just get like three taps at low percent if you don't have an up throw.
Yeah, I mean, assuming you're not going for the chain grab, but that's
true.
An option that you have, right? You don't go for the same combo every time.
True.
I do though.
Oh wow. And see? Even though he got the misfire. It didn't matter.
The Luigi gods are like, fuck. We had that.
If he was a few pixels higher, he would have slid along the stage. But instead he just went right into the wall. And it was a very easy edge guard. All he had to do is refresh his invincibility and grab it again.
What a shame.
This is how
edge
guarding
works. Like, you think like a kindergartner rage quit?
Nah, I don't think so.
Okay, right, so we're gonna be seeing some chain grabs happening, right? But he knows.
So what makes this stage so good for Luigi?
It's
chain grabs.
Not. Yeah. It basically.
What makes this the go-to counter pick for Luigi?
Against Spaces, I think it's just easy combos. You don't have to worry about platforms.
True.
I think the chain grab is a huge thing. I don't think a lot of the Luigis that I know who don't do the chain grab rarely counterpick here. They try to avoid it.
Okay, so
but it
where
boils.
Where the Luigi counterpick that?
It basically.
Wow, that was so good. Did you see that?
Yeah.
That was really smart.
Oh no.
Our monitor
I can't. Oh, no, we're back. I think it boils the matchup down to just kind of linear movement back and forth, which is where Luigi excels.
True. Not in every matchup, though, because for some characters it's very easy to just kind of stuff his linear movement because know Marth, that all he's doing.
Marth is what you're saying.
Marth is one of those characters. I can imagine that Fox would have an easy time. Maybe not.
Yeah.
Oh, whoa. Gosh.
That was the best thing that could have happened.
See, he assumed that Luigi was not going to get a misfire. If he had assumed, he would have held shield, waited for it, ran over enough times.
I think back air is like stupidly good against Luigi.
You can just wall him out.
Back air and up tilt is just going to stop Luigi from coming in. Although I will say, that forward tilt is like a godsend for the character of Luigi. Because it's his one, he gets a sword for one move.
I completely respect it. I don't think that was
hilarious. I know, but I respect it anyways.
Okay.
Were you expecting that?
No.
No one was. Maybe up smash there would have done something. I don't know.
I'm not a Luigi player.
Not a Luigi expert, yeah. I know a lot of them.
And that's why Fox is the best character in the game. He ran in. Up smash. Dead. 100%. That's the scrubby ledge dash, as some call it.
I think. Seems to be getting a lot of mileage from being patient, you know, letting Fox come in with something dumb, and then getting his follow from that.
True.
Because the one thing Luigi has over Fox is a better combo game against in the head-to-head.
Yes. But you see, there's so many instances where Fox will come in with something not dumb, and then, you know, wait, as I say that, there's so many times when Fox can come in with something that's just an amazing option.
Yeah. Yeah, but it's better than blindly running in and letting him just jump up and then shine in.
That's true. Yeah.
Do you like John Lennon?
I am a fan of his work.
I'm not a big fan of the Beatles.
Really?
Yeah. I respect them as artists individually, but like the sound of their music is not my favorite thing in the world.
I see. Well, I think the Beatles are cool. See, he's opting to switch to Falcon again, even though he won.
But here's the thing: Ilu plays Falcon as well, so he knows
everything about the character.
I think this is a very fun matchup to watch.
Really?
Yeah. Because I think they hurt each other really hard.
Do you have any insights onto how it's played?
How it's played
from Voodoo Jin.
Oh yes, actually, this was the matchup that made me come up with my Luigi spacing theory. So you want to stay like a few character lengths away from Falcon and move in and out of that point, right? All your movements is based around that, right?
As Luigi.
Yeah, and that's far enough away that if you can't immediately
see the up tilt.
Yeah, see, great move. It's just a combo extender.
So please go on.
Yeah.
So you stay a few character lengths away.
So we'd say that, which is close enough that he can quickly wave dash in and get something if he sees an opportunity, but it's far enough away that he can also react.
That Zedhogan can't just control the area.
Yeah. And I watched a full set of like 5 games with Voodoo Jin, I think, against like Nakamaru.
I'm not familiar with
him. He played Falcon. He's on like the Pittsburgh PR or something. I saw that was kind of his game plan with the spacing. And it ended up working out in his favor, so.
Well,
because if it's
working well right now.
If it's just we're going to move around on opposite sides and then we're going to run at each other and whoever picks the best option wins, then it's anyone's game.
That's melee. Have you ever thought about
that's
that?
My
that's
game
pretty
plan.
Much melee. It's not really, but that's a lot of low-level melee.
Movement is the best attack in the game.
It's true. If you have better movement than the other player, and then, well, at low level, If you have good movement and someone does not, it's over. It's free. You don't even need to, like, think about how they're playing.
You're just in and out.
The players you're watching right now do not fall victim to either of the things.
That was a very smart thing. He was behind him. Yeah, and the hitbox was a little bit behind him. It was crazy. I think my commentary is at its best when I'm not talking about Melee.
I feel like we should be, as commentators,
we owe it.
That, like, you should be talking about Melee.
Who's going to be
Can
watching
your
this?
Commentary actually be good?
No.
While not talking about Melee?
Yeah. Uh-oh. It's just interesting.
And that is Captain Falcon in a nutshell. Three up airs.